Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all for coming tonight. We started with an overture by the American composer Cesare Giovannini. I remember hearing his music, although I didn't know his name at the time, on the Kukla, Fran, and Ollie show. If you don't know what that is, you're probably under the age of 70, so find some old person and ask them. They'll tell you what Kukla, Fran, and Ollie is. But he went on to write some very fine music, including that overture. Middlebury Community Wind Ensemble would like to salute the centennial of the Ilsley Library here in Middlebury. Is Dana Hart here, the director of the library? Dana, is she here? No, not here. She was helpful in spreading the word about the next piece that we're going to do. Also helpful was Nancy Rucker, who is an archivist there, and Eva Garcelon Hart, who is the chief archivist. Are they here? The archivist books. Okay, well, they were very helpful. It turns out that in 1907, a local man from Cornwall who played in the Middlebury Town Band, played cornet, whose name was T.L. Eales, he wrote a piece in honor of Colonel Ilsley, who went on to leave in his will some money to build the library in 1923. And that piece of music, it's a piano piece, is in the Sheldon Museum. I was able, with the help of those people I mentioned, to see it and photograph it. It seems to me that it's almost certain that there was a piano, that there was a band version of this, because Eales played in the town band, and he played cornet, he wrote other things for cornet. But if that is the case, that score is lost. So, in any case, we turned it into a band piece anyway, and so imagine that it's 1907 and you are either Colonel Ilsley or Mrs. Ilsley, and the town band is playing this piece in your honor. It might have sounded something like this. And I'm going to show you how unnecessary a conductor is. I'm going to go play cymbals.
Thank you.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah.
Real time machine. So you've been enjoying some fine oboe playing up here, and it turns out that that oboe player also sings really well, so we're going to enjoy two Gershwin songs. Please welcome Gwen Delgadillo.
My dreams. No, no,
Next piece on our program is a transcription of a Debussy prelude. I'm not going to attempt the French pronunciation, but the English translation is The Sunken Cathedral. And I'm going to ask its transcriber to say a few words about it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Jack Clay.
There's some notes in the program about what Debussy was trying to do with this piece. I first encountered this piece, I think, in high school in a music appreciation class, and when I heard it, I thought, this must be a piano condensation of an orchestral or a large piece, because the colors and the music is so big. You know, and I was a horn player, I didn't think piano could do anything like that. So I thought, I'd like to play that, but then, you know, life went on. And some years later, I came back to it, and I thought, you know, I could probably do something for a symphonic band like this group or a concert band. So I checked, I looked on the internet, I couldn't find any arrangements. I thought it'd be fun to play this. So there weren't any, I just decided to do it myself. And that's what we're gonna play. I'd like to thank Jerry for looking at the score and thinking, hey, we can do this. And I'd like to thank all these guys up here for working hard at it. This is not an easy piece to play. Very simple, but it's not easy. Thank you.
Thank you, Jack. And just briefly to talk about the picture of what you're going to hear, the Breton myth is that there's a cathedral underwater. And every once in a while, on a nice day, it comes up out of the water. Water dripping off it, and we hear the monks chanting, we hear the organ playing, very big, very grand, and then it sinks back down. And when it's way down there submerged, we still hear all that music coming, but it's sort of all underwater.
Thank you.
March that was written in honor of a transplanted Vermonter, someone who was born in Brooklyn and moved to Vermont. We're going to hear a similar piece, similar in certain ways, a march written in honor of someone who was from Staten Island but came to Vermont. She actually came up to be a farm bride, a farm wife at the age of 19 and stayed in Vermont the rest of her life. And Nanny went on to have 12 grandchildren. I'm the oldest. The youngest is the composer of the next piece. He's actually here, and I think we can get him to come up and say a few words about his composition, and maybe actually conduct it too. Ladies and gentlemen, Ken Bagley.
Ensemble for inviting me up and allowing me to take part in this. Yes, we do share that distinction of being the bookends of the Nanny grandchildren. The only person I ever heard call her Madeline is her brother, Uncle Jimmy. One day after one of my concerts, my mom said to me, "Oh, Kenny, you should write a march for Nanny. She loved a good march." And as children and grandchildren, we always heard Nanny singing, and one of her favorite tunes was I Love You Truly. We heard that all the time. And the reference to barbershop in the program notes is many of our family is involved in barbershop. Jerry and Lindy and my brothers and sisters are involved in barbershop, and Nanny was at one of the concerts, and someone mentioned to one of the guest quartets there that Nanny sings. And she started to sing I Love You Truly, and this internationally known and championship quartet stood around her and sang the harmony while she sang the melody, and they adopted our grandmother, and any concert that she was at, no matter where or when, they would invite her up on stage and they would sing I Love You Truly with Nanny. And so that's the barbershop reference in this, and it was just a great deal of fun to put this march together in her honor, and I joked with my mom that this was a commission, and the price was one hug, and I did make her pay, so this is paid up, which is good. So it's been a pleasure for me to get to make music my whole life, and in a family that makes music, and so we hope you enjoy Madeline's March.
Thank you.
So, how many other Nanny descendants are out there? Let's hear it from you. There they are. My cousin's here. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce our manager, someone we could not function without, Karen Swanson.
Hello, and welcome to our winter concert. We are honored, first and foremost, that you've chosen to include this concert in your seasonal festivities. Thank you. As Jerry said, my name is Karen Swanson, and I'm now the manager of this August ensemble. But on that note, for those of you who have been here before, you've probably seen my colleague in the trumpet section, Michelle McHugh, stand here. And I have the honor of trying to step in and give her a little bit of a break. But I tell you, there's some mighty big shoes to fill there. And I just wanted to say thank you to Michelle for the countless years. On behalf of my colleagues on stage, I wanted to say just a few thank yous. As Jerry has already shared, this program has lots of local connections. And thanks go to both the Sheldon Museum and the Ilsley Library for their enthusiastic support when we came up with the Ilsley March as part of their centennial. It was just a wonderful connection, and we're really delighted and thank them for their support. Thanks also again to Michelle McHugh and also to Jen Burdock in the clarinet section for their help in unearthing the original march and digging up hard-to-find information about Mr. Eales, the composer of the march. We are also indebted to our friends at both the Middlebury Union High School and Mount Abe Union High School, who made rehearsal space available to us throughout the fall, and also to the Middlebury College Department of Music, who helped make this evening's concert possible. Thank you to all of them. It's also our honor to showcase lots of local Vermont talent in tonight's program. We're thankful for the special gifts our soprano soloist and oboist, Glenn Delgadillo, has shared with us. Thank you, Glenn. And also to our in-house managers, arrangers, orchestrators, whatever, both Jerry, who you'll hear his work shortly, but then also to Jack. Thank you to both of them. And it was a special treat to have Ken Bagley join us on stage as well to guest conduct his piece. Thank you. We're grateful to each and every one of you. So, if you've attended our concerts in the fall, you've seen most of us before, but I would like to take just a moment to introduce some new members that we have. So please stand when you hear your name. We have Anna Laufenberg and Joelle Logan on the flute. We have Josh Kavard on trumpet. And in this now like massively enhanced horn section over there, we have Kristen Andrews and Barb Young. Fran Brown has joined us on the euphonium. And Calvin Ramling here behind me on percussion. May I also note that we like to recognize some of our student members who are with us. And both Calvin and Ben Fuller in the sax section are our students, and we're delighted to be able to include them in this community ensemble. So that's very cool. Special welcome to both of them. We also want to give a particularly warm thank you to Jerry Shedd, for his dedication to this ensemble, along with his wonderful leadership, his high expectations, and also his patience, as he has helped us prepare this program over the last many months. And finally, most importantly, we thank you. We are honored to perform for you this evening and want you to know how much we value your support of live music in our community. So thank you, and enjoy the rest of this evening's concert.
Just just occurred to me this second that one of the things Nanny did was to go to the Grand Canyon and ride the mules, right? She did that, yeah. So that's where we're going. We're all going there, to the Grand Canyon, thanks to Ferdy Groffé. Another connection is that Ferdy Groffé orchestrated Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. We did Gershwin before, so another connection. So we go out to the Grand Canyon. We're going to start in the dark and experience the slow dawn, which starts with just a few crickets and ends up with some blazing sun. And then we're going to get to know one of those mules up close and personal and climb aboard for a little trip on the trail. And then finally, we'll see a glorious sunset, beautiful colors, and see that fade away so that we are back where we started in the peaceful dark. Grand Canyon Suite.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.